God could have created each and every new human being with a special act of creation, requiring no human participation at all. But in fact, in the world in which we actually live, new human beings come into existence as the result of interactions between a man and a woman. God wants our participation in his loving creation. He built this into our bodies. So let's just focus on one issue. What is owed to children? The Ruth Institute believes that every person has the right to know his or her cultural heritage and genetic identity. We believe that every child has the right to a relationship with his or her natural mother and father, except for an unavoidable tragedy. We sometimes hear people express concerns about children and their unequal access to things like schooling or housing or health care. But we have a different concern. Do kids have access to their own parents? Do kids even get to know who their parents are? Let's say that as good and decent people, we want to make sure that as many kids as possible get to live with their own mom and dad for their whole childhood. Well, how would we go about doing that? Well, for the child to be in relationship with both parents, we'd want the parents to be in relationship with each other first. We'd want them to have a plan for cooperating with each other in the raising of the child. We'd want these parents to get along reasonably well with each other. We'd want them to live together so the child doesn't have to change houses every weekend. And we want the plan to be a lifelong plan, not just a plan for 10 years or 18 years, but for life. After all, the relationship between parent and child is still important even after the children are grown. We'd also want to limit the drama that takes place when parents are involved with other people, drama that distracts parents from paying attention to the child and being considerate of the other parent. Of course, some distractions are inevitable. People do get sick and have accidents. But we'd want the adults to avoid the avoidable, namely passionate or sexual relationships with somebody who's not invested in the child. So how could we arrange for this kind of long-term cooperation between parents so that the child can have access to both of them without too much trouble?